Okay, welcome back, everybody. It is the top of the hour. We are trying something new this year. We are doing a lightning round. We have 5 10-minute presentations in the next 50 minutes. So we are going to start here with Reaching New Readers Through Writing with Amy Marshall, the director of the Craig Public Library in Alaska. Amy, you got 10 minutes. Off you go.
Okay, let's hope that this is going to work. Okay, Reaching New Readers Through Writing. Hi, I'm Amy Marshall. I'm from the Craig Public Library on Prince of Wales Island. As I told the bookaneer on Facebook, I've had copies where I'm ready. Craig is very remote. To give you an idea of how remote, we're 4 hours from the nearest Walmart by ferry. So this is a place that's very hard to get to. You may have heard of us. And just not known it. If you know Coatsy from Axemen, if you have watched Alaska's Bigfoot Island on Animal Planet, God help us, that's great. My library is, well, comparatively in the state, huge when you look at tribal libraries, but very small. I have 1,400 square feet, so it's not a big place. It is a place for the entire island. We have 1,400 people in Craig, 5,000 on the island. A very diverse population. We have fishermen that come in the summer. We have a huge native population. We have Tlingit and we have Haida. We have some Shimshin, but they're mostly over in Metlakatla. The island population can grow up to about 14,000 when the fishing fleet is in. So that kind of gives you an idea of where I'm coming from as far as doing these programs. One of the most discouraging quotes ever written for writers is this guy, Joseph Epstein. I'm sorry, dude, I've never heard of you until I heard this quote. I know that you're a writer. I know you've written 14 books. But if you're going to do anything to just squash anybody's creativity, you can't be a friend of mine. Because I think writing at its basic level is encouraging creativity. And libraries can have a big part of that. I mean, we're not just a place where books hang out. We need to be a place where people hang out, where people feel like they're going to create something. So I call it cradles of creativity, and I think that's a big deal. Chris Beatty and Ray Bradbury, that's my favorite. Your intuition knows what it wants to write, so get out of the way. Yeah. So, National Novel Writing Month. Yep. 30 days and nights of literary abandon.
Amy?
Okay. Yeah?
Could we have you just speak up just a little more? We're getting a little sound issues.
Oh, sorry. Okay,
there you
really
go.
Quick.
Thank you.
Okay, National Novel Writing Month. It's free. And NaNoWriMo.org, I don't know if you guys are familiar with this. They do something called Come Write In with Libraries and Coffee Shops. They started it in 2009. 75 libraries participated. That number has grown exponentially. In 2012, 350,000 participants and over 500 volunteers ran NaNoWriMo in 90 countries. So this is a huge deal. And there's a lot of support. It's a free program. And that, it's not going to take a lot on your part to get this running. To give you an idea, because somebody may come in and go, wow, 50,000 words in a month, what are you, nuts? Well, that's 1,667 words a day. And if you look at 50,000 word books, Great Gatsby, Brave New World, Catcher in the Rye, you know, all these right here. So, you know, it's something that you set yourself up for. Kids program. Now, this is not NaNoWriMo. This is a different program. They do partner with NaNoWriMo. I use this for my elementary school kids. Studentpublishing.com. It's free. What we did was a You're the Author at Your Library program. I had kids from kindergarten through fifth grade sign up for this thing. We wrote in the library. They wrote at school. I went and talked to the teachers and the parents. This K-1 class, Carrie Bennett's K-1 class, wrote a book together. It's called The Gingerbread Kid. It's set on Prince of Wales Island. It's absolutely hysterical and cute, and the kids did all the illustrations. What you do is you compile these things, you send them in to studentpublishing.com, they send you a book. And once again, it's free, so it's within your budget. I mean, it takes a little bit of time commitment. And this is my absolute favorite, because you don't think preschoolers and toddlers could write. They can. I found this book, The Real Champion of Staying Awake. In this story, the little girl wants to stay awake, so she tells each of her stuffed animals a story, and this is how she stays awake. So the kids were just enthralled, and I had these very weird, huge, book-shaped things that somebody donated from Oriental Trading Company, and I broke these out. I said, do you guys think you can tell a story? Well, my toddlers and preschoolers are grabbing every adult in the library and sitting down with them and telling them the story, and the adults are writing them down. The Young Writers Program, 13 and above, We had five in 2010. Two of them reached the 50,000 goal. This kind of gives you a breakdown of what you need to do beforehand. Advertise, go into the schools, talk to them. There's a free kit that you can get from NaNoWriMo. Chris Angotti is the Young Writers Program Director there. This is a screenshot of their Young Writers Program website. It's wonderful because the kids can go in, they make their own login, we can connect with writers all over the world. And there are forums that they can chat with writers all over the world. And what we found at the library is if we give them space and encouragement and time, it's amazing what they come up with. In the summer, I have a Young Poet Society and a Young Writers Guild. They come in, we write poetry, we write, and this all happens before the library opens on a Monday morning. So it's a time commitment on my part, which I'm totally into. It's absolutely great. And they come in, and we get together, and we write. The NaNoWriMo Classic Program, basically 17 and above. This is the screenshot for the Come Right In. The stuff that they will send you, they're an incredibly approachable group. And if you have any questions, you can call them on the phone. You can email them. They get back to you really, really quickly. And just like the Young Writers Program, there are forums there that when folks go and they register, they can talk to anybody, you know, all over the world, talk about writing. Most important part, it's a writing group, not a reading group, not a critiquing group. And that's one thing that you'll find when you get this started, because people are like, well, I write alone, and I don't want to be around anybody when I'm writing. And people are going to be reading my stuff, and that's not necessarily what happens in these groups. Resources, this is great. Even if you don't do a writing group, if you ever have writer's block, it's called Write or Die. You can set it to different modes. If you put it to electric shock and evil, if you hesitate more than 5 seconds, it will go backwards and start taking away your words. So it's in your best interest to keep writing. And I've used this with the young writers, and it's been a lot of fun. More resources, Storyist, I Write Like, which is a lot of fun. You take something that you've written and you cut and you paste it into this screen, and it tells you if you write like Robert Louis Stevenson and Margaret Atwood or Douglas Adams. At the end of all things, even in the Young Writers Program, there's a certificate at the end, and who doesn't like a certificate with the name and the title of your book? So it's just kind of something fun that you get at the end of the program, at the end of November. Afterwards, they partner with CreateSpace. If you take your book and you can go through the edits until the end of June, put it on CreateSpace, they will send you 5 copies of your book. And I'll tell you something. With these young writers and the older writers alike, there's nothing like holding your book in your hands. So this is free. This is free for them once they sign up for NaNoWriMo. The book doctors are two literary agents out of New Jersey who are absolutely fabulous. They wrote a book called The Essential Guide to About Everything You Wanted to Know to Get Your Book Published. And they do something around the country called Pitchapalooza. And what they're doing is they realize that publishing houses need new blood, need authors, and that's their mission. Other programs offered through the Office of Letters and Light, that's the parent organization of NaNoWriMo, is Camp NaNoWriMo, coming up in April, and then again in June. It's kind of like NaNoWriMo, right? They have a different website for it, it's a whole lot of fun. You can see this is mine, because it says how do you give me news from that. Who I am over there. You can take it further, and we did. In August of 2012, we did the Alaska Statewide Pitchapalooza and a Week of Literary Mayhem. We got a grant from IMLS. We used money from the state and the Alaska Owl Project. Alaska Owl Project is our broadband initiative. It also brought video conferencing to 104 libraries in the state. And we did Pitchapalooza from the Craig Library with the book doctors and the principals of NaNoWriMo. The NaNoWriMo guys did writing workshops over this thing. We had libraries all over the state hook up, and then the book doctors did 3 Pitchapaloozas. We had 3 winners. We had 3 book contracts come out of it. It was a great way to get exposure for Alaskan writers, because it's really hard to get exposure as a writer in Alaska just because you're so far away from everything. But If you want to contact me and you want me to put you in contact with the book doctors or Pitchapalooza, it is a lot of fun to have at your library. Here are some web resources. just kind of a breakdown, so you would have this slide so you would be able to get a hold of these people. And if you have questions, just ask. This is me everywhere. And my email, our library website, me on Twitter, the library on Twitter, me on Facebook, library on Facebook, on and on, Google Plus, LinkedIn. And I'm happy. I have the library gene, so I'm pathologically helpful.
All right.
10 minutes.
All right. Thanks, Amy. That was absolutely wonderful, and you stuck right to 10 minutes. So congratulations for that.